Caribbean. It got started in 2009 where I wanted to work with children in developing countries. Uh-huh. I researched and planned a trip to Guatemala, and in that research read about the dangers of street kids. While I was in Guatemala, I came across a child who was on the streets that was shooed away. Mm. He was about 6 years old, had no shoes, and looked like he was in need, and no one was helping. So right there, I kind of realized that there was a need. Yeah. Featuring renditions of some of the lives of the kids that we've impacted, a very inspirational night where we are going to be having a large surprise unveiling of the new direction of the nonprofit, as well as cocktails, past appetizers, and lots of fun live activities going on with our artists.
And Liz has been painting away over there. And the tie-in is you're actually going to be doing live painting at the event.
Yes, yes, exactly. So you'll really be able to be a part of the creative process, and you'll get to see some of the portraits of the kids that have been impacted by the organization.
Oh, so you do some of the portraits of the kids that have been impacted.
Yep.
As well as what will you be live painting at the event? People?
We'll be doing portraits as well. Yeah.
Oh, neat. And Liz, what's your background? How did you get interested?
So, you know, a friend told me about the organization, and I looked into it, and I just thought it was absolutely amazing that they were doing, you know, just so many amazing things with kids and, you know, kids in developing countries that just really need our help. And the fact that it was, you know, a fellow Chicagoan that was doing this, I just felt really compelled to, you know, offer any help that I could give. So, yeah. Neat.
So if people could have one takeaway about your organization, what would it be?
You know, we inspire the community to get involved and help us make this change.
We appreciate it. And you can learn more information about Charity for Life and the Believe in Possible fundraising event.
I was watching that one on the edge of my seat last night. It is a big day for White Sox fans. The Sox Fest.
Eyewitness News reporter Diane Patrick is live with more from Wrigley. Diane?
You said it so well, Ben. That's right. You really did connect with so many people on and off the field, and that's what people will remember the most. In fact, lots of people stopping by this morning.
It's free.
If you really like the cold, you can take a dip in the lake right here at Oak Street Beach for the Lakeview Polar Plunge.
I was passing away at the age of 83. The Banks family plans to hold a news conference tomorrow afternoon. Reporting live at Wrigley, Diane Patrick, ABC 7 Eyewitness News.
All right, so many memories. Thank you for that, Diane. Political leaders are also remembering Ernie Banks. This morning, President Obama and First Lady. Other news that we're following this morning, a junior high school teacher is charged this morning with sexually abusing two students. The alleged incidents happened in southwest suburban Orland Park. The accused teacher, Kara Labus, lives in Joliet. Eyewitness News reporter Eric. There is no official cause of death yet for Ernie Banks, but it's really his life that people are remembering this weekend. Eyewitness News reporter Diane Patsy was live at Wrigley Field, where fans are really having an emotional reaction this morning. Diane?
It's been an amazing morning, Stacey, and that people have been stopping by and shedding a tear and sharing their story of how they personally met Ernie Banks and how he touched their lives forever and how they're never going to forget him. Not only was he a legend on field, but off as well. The marquee here at Wrigley Field says it all. They are honoring Mr. Cup today. Ernie Banks was the first African.